This is another one I'll never get. Spirit Tomb. Well, I know Spirit Tomb isn't exactly the best looking thing, and it's possible that maybe its crazy looks scared people from using it, or scared people from facing it. I've had to smile on just as scared of it personally, and want to make it UU so that people won't use it. Whatever the case, right, this Pokemon, as I'm sure you know, has no weakness. Just that one reason, in my opinion, should give it at least a borderline tier, and if not an OU. Right, to have a Pokemon with no weakness is rare, very rare. In fact, there's only two Pokemon of the 493 that can have this. Right, the other one is Sableye. This one is Spiritomb. The Spiritomb has really good defenses. Not too good on the HP, but it can learn Pain Split and Rest, which can help it out. Right, it can learn Nasty Plot, it learns Hypnosis, and many special attacking moves like Shadow Ball, Dark Pulse, Dream Eater, you name it. Right, even Ominous Wind, although I wouldn't recommend that. But fact remains, this Pokemon should be OU in my opinion, because it's got no weak points, right, which automatically makes it one of the most unique Pokemon going next to Sableye. Right, it can learn a dozen of neat moves, you know, including Sucker Punch, you know, so that'll help it out of its low speed stat. But in my opinion, this Pokemon doesn't even need a speed stat, because it's so good on defenses. I'm not saying it's invincible, there's no such thing as an invincible Pokemon, but I think it should be OU. When you consider the fact that there are so many physical attackers in the OU metagame, it would seem logic to use Steelix. You know, and I've got to be right. Right, every battle I have seen, right, in Steelix Inn, when it comes to Weavile, I think this thing laughs at it. You know, I think all the battles I have watched on YouTube from Mewtarn and Charizard 3 and many others, right, every time Steelix has come up against a Weavile, Steelix just laughed at it. Weavile can learn Brick Break, and even that doesn't even KO it. Right, when you consider how much Weavile is used on the OU metagame and many other physical attackers, it just doesn't seem logic that Steelix is UU. I don't get it at all. I know it's not the best on special defense, but hey, how many OU sweet physical attackers are there? You know, we've got Weavile, Skarmory, Hippowdon, Tyranitar, we used to have Garchomp. You name it, we've got loads of physical attackers in the OU metagame. So why isn't Steelix OU? Well, I don't get it at all. Now, I can respect people's opinions on this one. Mind you, I respect people's opinions on all of them. But in my opinion, Steelix should be OU. Right. I admit, I don't use Steelix that much myself, but I should, to be honest. I should listen to myself sometimes. You know, I just think Steelix should be OU when you consider how many OU Pokemon are physical. At last, we come to the last one. Right, Yanmega. Right. I'll be honest here. I think Smogon sometimes just don't pay attention to what they're doing. Right, this Pokemon is UU. Why is it UU? Right, it should be OU. Right, it just should be OU in my opinion. Right, it's got really good speed, and it's also got speed boost. Speed boost is a rare ability. In my opinion, this is similar to Spiritomb, just different situation. It's got a very rare ability. I think only Ninjask and Yanmega can learn Speed Boost, unless you count Yanma, the pre-evolved form of Yanmega. Right, I don't get it at all. Right, this Pokemon should be OU, no problem. It can learn Hypnosis for quite loud. It can learn Protect and Detect. You know, and it can learn lots of nice special attack moves like Hidden Power, Bug Buzz, Air Slash. You know, so many. You know, and Psychic. So why is this thing UU? Once again, if you want to share any of your thoughts, feel free. You know, because I don't get why this Pokemon isn't OU. It's got a really good ability, a rare ability as well. You know, and it can learn lots of moves that are OU material. You know, so why is Gamega UU? If someone please explain to me why, then I'd be grateful. And so there you have it. Those are all the Pokemon that I think should have a higher tier. But if you are a bit against what I said, then I can understand where you're coming from. Yeah, but this is solely my opinion. Right, if you disagree, then, you know, feel free to comment. You know, I don't want to start an argument or anything, but I just love hearing people's opinions. Right, so, yeah. Okay, and if you watch both of these parts, then thanks so much for taking the time to listen to me. And I hope you look forward to the next vlog.